working as a senior manager of design at Global Gadget, and I am here to present on Internet of Things. In short, we call it IoT. Now, usually when you speak to someone about IoT, there's a lot of technical jargon involved, too much of Hadoop and big data and stuff that comes in. So this presentation is from a UX perspective. So as UX designers, how does IoT impact us and how we can leverage it to provide the best of the user experiences? So these are everyday things that we see in life. A flower pot, a watch, our home, disaster management. Now you may think that how does a flower pot get into the scene of IoT? Now there are many devices. So one such device is called this flower power, and this device has actually got sensors for Wi-Fi. It connects to Wi-Fi. It can measure sunlight, humidity, temperature, and what happens is that it feeds into a cloud. And all this data is shown up on your mobile device. So it lets you know when your plant needs fertilizer, when it needs water, and such things. So that way, this flower pot is now on the IoT. It is generating some data, and it is helping you take decisions on whether your plant is doing well or not. So in the same way, we have seen how the watch has become a smartwatch. We are using augmented reality to control appliances in our home. So smart homes have come in, Apple has come up with the home kit, and then disaster prediction. So this is again something which is existing, it's nothing new. There are many such sensors across oceans and lands which figure out earthquakes, figure out tsunamis, and give us the warning in advance so we can take appropriate action. So now the question is, what is IoT? I won't give you a definition because you'll get a lot of different definitions on the web, but I will give you the concept of IoT. So what you see here are sensors and actuators. So let's say there's a door lock and you have a So let's say if you have a door lock and you have a key using which we open it, there could be a magnetic key as well. You attach a magnet to the lock and it opens up. But this thing is not an IoT because there is no data being generated. This device is not identifiable. It is just a unit by itself. Even though it has a sensor and an actuator, the sensor senses the magnetic strip and the actuator which opens the lock, but it is not on the IoT. The moment it starts interacting with a system such as a cloud, which has got server, database, analytics, or with the device, so any of these bidirectional relationships will establish the IoT concept. So every time, let's say these days you get these small beacons, they are just Bluetooth devices and they are as big as this coin, and you can fix it anywhere. So let's say if you have fixed this in your car, when you walk into your car, your mobile phone app can figure out whether there's a beacon in here, there's a signal coming out, it can change the entire interface of the mobile device to show up navigation and stuff on the home screen, play the music of your choice, and such things can be done. Any questions here? Quick questions I can take?
Yeah. I heard about something like, you know, we can put a device to a car, any mobile, an automobile, and if someone touches or something happens to the car, it will give you a message to your mobile. Is there something else?
Yeah, so a lot of different things are there. And it's a bigger explanation, I'll take it up with you after the session. Now, I'll come to some actual application of IoT. So something that we have done in actual implementation. So the first case I'm showing to you is IoT in retail. So if you are shopping in some place in US, you often have a lot of offers or coupon codes with you. And often you would have a wish list. But you don't figure out that which coupon applies to which item in my wish list, and you often lose out on the opportunity to make a discount purchase. Apart from that, often you have some items that you want to buy, but you're not able to locate where it is on the aisles. Now think of this scenario, that if you had a wish list on your mobile phone, and if you're walking by a store, the app on your mobile can figure out that certain items on your wish list are there in the store available at an offer that you have on your mobile device. So we made an app for this for a major departmental store in US. And what we did was that each of the shelves have got these small beacons on them. And on the back end, the beacon IDs are tied to what items are available on those shelves. So a person is walking by those shelves, they're able to figure out that what items of their choice are available here at an offer which can benefit to them. We also did this payment system in which you don't have to actually go and swipe your card. Your data is stored on your mobile phone. So you could actually make the purchase not only through a physical swipe of the credit card. One more thing that we did over here was that you could also, so let's say if you are going out shopping and maybe watching a movie with your family, you wouldn't want to carry around all that stuff with you. So when you are buying the items in the shop, you could just scan the barcode and say I want to buy this item and add it to your virtual card, not to a physical card that you have in the store, but to a virtual card. And when you are checking out, you can say deliver to my home. So once you make the payment, at a later stage, you can go enjoy a movie and stuff, and the stuff gets delivered to your home like you would do an online shopping, but then this gives you the physical touch of the store. Similar thing in security services. So how do you apply IoT in access control, or how it can help us do things in a better way? So we all carry our mobile devices all the time, but then we are having to carry an access card as well. And at times, if we need to access certain areas where we don't have access to, we have to go to the admin department, get the access and then come back there and then access that area which is not given to us by default. So here what we are doing is that we are again using the same concept, and when the user walks into a door, the door automatically unlocks for him. So there's no need to pick out your access card, swipe it on the gate and then get inside. As you approach the door opens for you. Through the system, kind of. So in this way, that part is very smooth now. Apart from that, if there is any device, for example, if you have a laptop with you, when you enter the office, you have to make an entry in the register that okay, I have got this laptop with me. When you walk out, you do the same thing once again. Now if you attach one such beacon to the laptop inside it, whenever you are entering or exiting the building, the data is being recorded automatically. So in that way, your laptop, even though it is on the internet as it is, but then now it becomes a device on the IoT in the way of access control, in the way of security services. Now, IoT and energy, so this isn't that something that we've done, this is just a concept that we have. So, IoT ties up very much, very closely with big data and with gesture-based interfaces. Okay. So now imagine there is a wind farm, and this wind farm has got about 50 windmills. Each of these windmills have got about 10 sensors. They sense humidity, wind speed, the rotation speed of the blades, the temperature, the amount of vibration in that equipment, and all these things. So imagine 10 sensors sending data every 10 seconds for 50 windmills. It's a huge amount of data. Now, if you had to create a user interface for that, kind of a dashboard, how would you do that? Normally it would be a dashboard with lots of things blinking here and there, red, green and blue, and that would make no sense to the end user. Now if you had an interface of something of this kind, wherein the user can interact with those in a kind of an environment that is more closer to the physical environment, and the difference, any alerts could be shown, the power generation could be shown, and all of that could be done through a gesture-based interface. If you take it a step further, what happens with the technicians is that the people who are on the field, now they have to go and check each and every windmill, how it is working good or not, is there any problem with that? So it takes a long time to do that. Now imagine if you could give them an augmented reality based interface, if they could just scan the horizon with their mobile device, and the same data which was there in the control center can show up over here in this kind of an interface, that will help the technician identify easily that which windmill needs attention, and they can go and attend to it immediately. So So there are a lot of companies who are already in this field of IoT, and one such company is Google. You would have already known they have got this Android Wear, Dropcam, Google Fit, Android TV, Auto, Nest, and Google Glass. Nest was a recent acquisition, Dropcam also was an acquisition. Now these again are devices. So this Nest is a thermostat, and it actually keeps learning from your user, from the user behavior. So if you have installed Nest as a thermostat in your home, and you set it to a certain temperature, it will know, okay, this date, this time, this temperature, and over a period of 3-4 days, it will figure out the pattern. And it again uses the Wi-Fi, it uses the cloud, it has analytics out there, and that way, it helps people by giving them a very good experience over a period of days. There are many other key players in this field. Apple, as we know, has got HealthKit and HomeKit. Mercedes-Benz is doing a lot of things in the space of predictive user experiences. So what they do is that they use again the same sensor data and they figure out the user's behavior and the pattern. So what happens in this thing is that they, by default, Mercedes car would have an occupancy sensor in every seat and a weight sensor. Now the same data now they are using to enhance the user experience. And how they are doing that is that if they sense that a driver's seat is occupied and there is a certain weight, so they know that the driver is there on the seat, and over time the pattern is that this driver goes to a cafe house and then to the office. So next time, once the pattern is identified, the driver doesn't have to show me directions to this place or play this music. That happens automatically. So the amount of touch points or interactions for the end user goes down. The system is getting more and more predictive. Now let's say the car senses that there is a child. So weight is less, occupied seat, which means there's a child in there. Then the car first goes to the school, then to cafe, then to office. In the same way, the car will customize the experience for the driver. So that is how Mercedes is using IoT to enhance customer experiences. A lot of these companies are doing a lot of innovative stuff. And now that's what my presentation is so far. I am open to questions now.